Manon Rheaume was in the net last night when the Tampa Bay Lightning took on St. Louis in an NHL preseason game. Manon Rheaume is a woman.
Born in Lac Belleport, Quebec, Manon Rheaume grew up watching her brothers out on the ice while her father would coach. And when her brothers Martin and Pavel were able to skate, he allowed both boys to be a part of his team. Her dad Pierre concentrated on training the players as skaters and puck handling machines. His emphasis was on skill rather than scrimmages, and because of this, no one on the team trained to play in goal. Manon, watching from the outside, knew this, and convinced her father to let her play in net, and because of his decision, it would help Rheaume reach the Atom Division, where she'd help her team win the championship in 1983, and after this experience, many would question if Rheaume was as good as she was. After graduating from Atom Hockey, Manon tried out for the Pee Wee AA team, but was cut. Both she and her father believed it was because she was a girl, but this wouldn't stop Manon as she'd play a lower level of Pee Wee hockey and was a standout, helping her team place first in the region and allowing Rheaume to achieve her dream of playing in the International Pee Wee Tournament, and by doing so, she became the first girl to participate in the tournament's 25-year history. This would later attract a team in Sherbrooke, and after having major success winning numerous championships, Rheaume would receive two great opportunities, ones that would leave huge impacts on Rheaume and fans across the world. 1992, Rheaume would make her international debut in the IIHF Women's World Hockey Championships in Finland. She'd rotate with goaltender Marie-Claude Waugh till the semifinals, where she'd play in goal full time. And in the gold medal game, Rheaume would post a shutout, helping Canada win 8-0 against the United States. She'd win the tournament's top goaltender award and would be selected to the 1992 All-Star team, but her time in net wouldn't end there, as she'd also be the first girl to suit up for a game in the QMJHL, being able to play alongside of her brother, Pavel. Things were looking up for Manon, but it'd get even better when Lightning general manager Phil Esposito approached her with an offer she'd never forget. After her win against the United States in the championship game, Phil Esposito of the Tampa Bay Lightning invited her to attend training camp, letting her try out to play goalie on the team. The Lightning at the time were a brand new franchise and were placed in a non-traditional hockey market, so the whole tryout was widely viewed as more of a publicity stunt. However, everyone was shocked when Rheaume made it past the first round of cuts, and even more surprised when it was announced she would play in the first period of a preseason game against St. Louis. She'd allow 2 goals on 9 shots, and because of this, she'd officially become the first woman to play an NHL game. But that wasn't all. She'd also become the first girl to appear in any of North America's major professional sports leagues. Rheaume was making history, and also living a dream. She'd be invited to numerous TV and talk shows and would inspire young girls to want to make it big. However, her stint in the NHL would come to an end, but she'd still continue to set many firsts soon after. Once her time in the NHL was over, she'd then pursue her hockey career elsewhere, as the IHL Atlanta Knights would ink Rheaume to a 3-year contract, where she'd play as a third-string goaltender. She would play 2 games with the Knights, including an entire game where Rheaume would give up 6 goals in an 8-6 loss. For the next 5 seasons, Manon would bounce from team to team, and by 1997, Rheaume would play for 7 total teams. However, during that time in 1994, she'd be selected to play once again in the World Championship, where she'd take home her 2nd gold medal. This wouldn't be Rheaume's last international appearance, however, as she'd approach an even larger stage, a stage that would attract even more people and more attention to Manon. 1998, the Winter Olympics, the first Olympics to feature women's hockey. Rheaume's poster girl status to this point made everyone want to tune in and watch her play, but this didn't distract her, however, as once again, her team would appear in the gold medal game, and she'd start in net. But the storybook ending wouldn't take place, as Rheaume would give up 2 goals before getting pulled. Canada would lose 3-1, and the team would get silver, Canada's first Olympic medal in women's hockey. Rheaume tried out for Team Canada in 1999, but didn't make the cut. and announced her retirement from the national team a year later. In 2001, Rheaume played forward in the NWHL before hanging up her skates there. She'd eventually come out of retirement to play a couple games in net for the Minnesota Whitecaps and play two more games in men's leagues before officially retiring from hockey. Rheaume has been a huge inspiration for many women who either play the game or watch at home. She did something not many were able to do, and that was break barriers. Rheaume worked hard, ignored the media, and kept moving forward. She knew she was a female playing in men's leagues, but she didn't let that define who she was as a player. Manon is still the only female to play in the NHL. Imagine if she and many others played full-time. It would completely change the game, much like Manon Rheaume did during one press conference in 1992.
If Manon become an NHL, I don't think it's going to be because she's a woman. Because she got the talent to play there, and I don't see nothing against that. If she's having the talent to play in NHL, it's fine with me.